UFO got me. I've been probed.
Watch. Now it's dark. Saturday nights on MTV.
You're watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend. You're watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
One last time, I have to see this ground. It's beautiful now, as if nothing had happened here. Soon they will tear down the main house, and then nothing will be left. Nothing. Except what I remember. I grew up in the town nearby, where my father was the mayor, and where this house stood, waiting for me. It was built by Wilfred Butler. We had never seen him, and he never lived at home. Until the day before Christmas in 1950, he finally did come back for the last time.
Trying to make a snow angel there.
All of us believed that his death was an accident. No one knew that another person had come to Butler House that Christmas.
Good evening. I'm Hank Miller, your host of Now It's Dark. We're watching Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972.
As deputy coroner of the county of Arlington, state of Massachusetts.
Directed by Theodore Michaud, co-produced by the medical examiner famous of this Lloyd county, Kaufman,
that the deceased, starring Alfred Butler,
Patrick O'Neill,
died as a result of burns inflicted accidentally upon himself on his own premises during the afternoon of December 24th, 1950. No further inquiry shall be held over the body of the deceased, and this inquest is officially closed.
Thanks for tuning in tonight, Atomic Boy, J-Mo Session, Rocky Munson, Anti-Postmodernism. Appreciate it. Now, this film is titled Silent Night, Bloody Night, but it was also re-released under the title of Death House. It's a special night tonight. We got some prize giveaways. We've got a special video presentation after the film. And of course, I'm finally back from vacation. I feel a little bit rested and glad to be hosting the show tonight. So tonight, we'll be giving away a Hank special edition coffee mug. So every caller that calls in tonight will be put into a drawing to win that coffee mug. Again, this is an interactive show. We'd love to hear from you. You can always call us and talk to Hank live on the air. And then, of course, you can always interact with us through the chat on Twitch.
After the coroner's inquest, on New Year's Day, they buried Wilfred Butler.
You want that opportunity to win that coffee mug? Phone lines are open. 520-329-2866.
Wilfred Butler, being of sound mind and body, at least what the world considers sound, do hereby leave my house and its grounds
a voiceover
and all personal effects within that house to my only surviving relation, my grandson, Jeffrey Butler. And I solemnly charge him with one duty.
Jeffrey Butler.
The house as I left it, standing untouched to remind the world of its inhumanity and cruelty.
For 20 years, that house lay empty, exactly as Wilfred left it. And then, last year, rumors began that it was finally being sold.
A lot of exposition.
The newspaper story traveled through the county to a state hospital.
SR211, thanks for joining us tonight. We aim to try. Thanks for watching tonight. Hard to drive to the Pike Ranch.
Hey,
Phone lines are open. You want an opportunity to win that mug? Give us a call, 520-329-2866. Oh my goodness, we have Madame Golan is on the chat tonight.
The man who came to sell the house had never seen it. He was a lawyer from the city, just doing a job and enjoying it.
This is a canon release film, and Mr. Golan, you are a big part of the canon company. So thrilled that you're watching tonight.
Oh, no. Hey, wait, where are you going now? The mayor's gonna have a fit, kid.
One more shot.
Come on.
Stay there. I want one together. And smile.
What an honor.
Stay tuned to WLIX, your voice of the Northeast. This is Roger Fowler with local stories. First, today's headlines. A warehouse fire still rages in Elizabeth. Police suspect arson. That escaped inmate in Margaret.
So right here is the actress Mary Warnoff, Rocky Munson, I think, was commenting earlier. The Mary Warnoff. She's a very famous actress, considered a cult actress, because she appeared in so many films, a lot of them Roger Corman films. Also worked extensively with Andy Warhol, as part of his entourage called the Warhol Superstars. Yeah. And from the great 80s indie film Eating Raoul. That's right, Rocky. It's a nice Jaguar. Phone lines are open. You want to give old Hank a call? 520-329.
Well,
didn't I tell you? 2866.
It's beautiful.
Can we see the rest of it?
Honey, that was it.
Jamie Obsession says she loves that movie, Eating Raoul. It's a great film, starring and directed by Paul Bartel.
Right. Laura always
and,
said that.
And Paul Bartel and Mary Warnoff actually appeared, I believe, in 17 films together. Much of the time... they were played man and wife in the films that they were in.
Sooner or later, that viaduct's gonna take us back home.
FCC Gila Ben, thanks for joining us tonight. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Phone lines are open, 520. If you want to win our coffee mug tonight, we'll have the phone lines open all night long. So if you'd like an opportunity to Hank in your house and have a cup of Hank every morning, give us a call tonight. We'll put you into the drawing to win that mug.
Mr. Carter.
Mr. Mayor.
Let me introduce you. This is Charlie Toman, who publishes our weekly newspaper.
Got it right there is the famous John Carradine.
Toman?
Patriarch of the Carradine family.
And this is Tess
of actors.
How do you do? She operates our switchboard.
Oh, really?
We call her the communications director. And this is Bill Mason.
Mason?
Our sheriff.
She answers the phones, and then she's a communications
sit
director.
There, Mr. Carter, at the head of the table.
Thank you. I didn't expect to meet you all together. It's quite a reception.
We'll be right back after these messages.
So, why am I here? It's a letter from a colleague in Chicago about a clairvoyant case. Richard, you're going to see the most amazing discovery I've ever made.
Where did you find her, between the bearded lady and the elephant man?
Professor Austin is a non-believer.
Science and religion often dismiss what they don't understand out of fear and ignorance.
This voyage is the best evidence I've ever come across.
You make an excellent subject. What's happening to us, Richard?
You don't know what you're dealing with.
If you can't find your way back.
Well, then I'd need to find a new body.
You're watching Channel 67. Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Something's coming, folks. Or in actuality, already here.
Oh my word, Buford, there's floating lights in the sky.
No, there ain't, woman.
Gosh darn it, I know what I've seen, Buford. I'm looking at them right now.
Agnes, you get back in this house this minute.
I think they're aliens, Buford.
There ain't no aliens. They're always seeing stuff in the sky that isn't really there.
Buford, I cook for you. I clean for you.
Oh,
don't tell me what I'm seeing over here. Listen, you...
They say the truth is out there, but it's happening right here in Gila Bend. Stay safe, my friends.
Operators are standing by. You're watching Channel 67. Amter TV. Broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Let's begin. As you know, I've been retained by Jeffrey Butler.
Oh, we're back.
Concerns the house that he inherited.
Hank Miller with Now It's Dark. We're watching Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972.
Go on, Mr. Carter.
I believe that you offered to buy the house for my client.
Directed by Theodore Gershani.
We begged him. We wrote letters.
Co-produced by the famous Lloyd Kaufman from Troma.
Trouble. Was always
starring Patrick O'Neill.
I spent the last
and the
20
famous
years
Mary Warnoff
driving people
and
away
John
from
Carradine.
There. Prowlers, burglars, kids, they're the worst. Chasing for nothing because of that will.
Thanks for joining us tonight, Doug
that
Ganger and Stock Trailer Mike.
Humanity. No.
Also,
inhumanity.
Rob,
what the hell is that, huh?
Rob Jen AZ. Thanks for watching in. Thanks for watching tonight.
Yes, well, he was a bitter man.
We also have a very special guest in the chat tonight, the Mr. Manon Golan, former chairman of Canon Films.
Well, some people are like that.
Thanks so much for watching tonight, Mr. Golan. So, Mr. Golan says, this film was originally released as Silent Night, Bloody Night, but in a re-release, it was titled Death House. We have a special giveaway tonight. the special edition Amateur TV, Hank Mugg.
The question is, well, do you still want the house?
Are you offering it to us, Mr. Carter?
Exactly.
So anybody who calls in tonight will be put in for a drawing to win the mug?
Well, that's Mr. Butler's business, isn't it?
You know,
oh my gosh, we got our first call tonight.
Most of us came here during the Depression. But we love this town.
You're live on there with Hank. What's your name, caller?
To improve it.
Exactly.
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
He fully sympathizes and he's willing to sacrifice the house.
Sonny.
For $50,000.
Where are you calling?
Hank Miller from Amateur TV.
By noon.
Yeah, this is Hank. Where are you calling from, Sonny?
Okay, I'm calling.
That's an awful lot of cash.
It's also an
awfully good bargain.
You could go to Wilton. You could go now to the bank.
You hear me?
We'll try and keep it down. Do you want us to put you in for the mug?
All that cash.
What mug?
The coffee mug we're giving away.
I'll wait for your answer till tomorrow.
I don't care. Keep the noise down.
You're spending the night here?
Yes.
May I ask where?
At the Butler House.
Thanks for calling.
We could put you up at the motel as our guest.
No, house is fine.
Guess we're disturbing the
Paradise
neighbors a little bit.
Motel. That's very kind of you.
But thanks for calling in, Sonny. We'll put you into the drawing.
You'll want a phone. I can reconnect the line.
Don't trouble, please.
No trouble. You'll need a phone.
Don't want to be stuck out there.
Mm-hmm. Well, you've convinced me. Thank you.
By the way, have you known Mr. Butler a long time?
FC Heelband saying it's a dope mug.
He called me and asked me if I'd handle this for him. I said,
what
yes.
I missed?
He had the key delivered to my office.
Who's Daryl?
Mayor.
FC Heelband. I think I missed something when I was on the phone with Sonny.
Howard, see you all tomorrow. In fact, I'm looking forward to it.
Is that the name of our character here in the movie? Well, we got our first call. Nobody else.
Slick, really slick.
Oh, we have another call.
Bill, you've got to expect that. Don't tell me about lawyers.
Oh, you see the way he looked at us? You see his clothes?
He's doing his job. Just don't tell me about lawyers. Oh. You know what I like to see?
It's like they hung up.
Two of them like that when talking to each
other. Hopefully, you can call back.
Know what to believe.
Get you on the air.
I love you too. Honey, when I get home, I'm going to have a nice surprise for you. No, I can't tell you what it is now. I wouldn't be surprised, would it? No, I can't come home now, but it'll be very soon. Very soon.
Bit of activity here. I'm missing the film.
Of course I miss you. Yes, I miss Mommy, too.
Daryl is...
Laura.
There we go.
All right, good.
The phone dream. Got another call.
So got a call tomorrow.
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Jenny.
Hey.
Yeah, well, as a matter of fact, I'm having a fine.
I'm sorry, who is it?
This is Doug from L.A.
The same to you, Doug.
Doug.
This is Jubilee Road.
What do you mean, hospital?
Oh, hey. So glad to hear from you. How are we coming in? What do we got? We got a conference call going here?
Yeah, we got a three-way.
Oh, three-way.
We're pretty sure Richard Dawson in this movie.
If we get it.
Where's Richard Dawson in his film?
What then?
Look, that's Richard Dawson. We're on the phone. I'm going with him right now.
Okay.
What's on your mind tonight, gentlemen?
I better get going.
Do me a favor,
Tess. It's a Canon release.
Call Diane.
Yes.
Tell her I'm going to Wilton, and I'll be back late.
I'm not quite sure what camera they used. I don't think it was a Nikon, but possibly.
Yeah,
C- Could have been a Claire or an Ari. I'm not sure. Definitely not a Panavision. You mean the gentleman that was ablaze? All right, for the drawing.
Enjoy the movie.
Oh, well, I'm glad, so glad you guys are watching. So for the drawing, we have Doug, and we have, I'm going to say, is that Herman from Portland?
Jubilee Rosen Cohen, that's
your service. Jubilee Rosen. All right, Julie, yes, thank you so much for playing our game on our Facebook page. I really appreciate that.
I like word finding games.
Thank you so much for calling in. We're gonna put you in the drawing.
It's fantastic.
And I hope you enjoy. We'll be talking about Paul Bartel a bit later, and Lloyd Kaufman, and connection with softcore porn and Oliver Stone. So please stay tuned.
It's grandfather's monument. You know, the caretaker who keeps.
Thank you for calling. Bye.
What kind of monument is this?
Now,
well, that's the trouble.
I believe that was
nobody remembers anymore.
Doug
that's
from
what
L.A., and we had, I'm sorry, something Jubilee from Portland, a.k.a. I think Herman Jolly. So thanks so much for calling in. Really appreciate that.
And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells.
Looks like cult leader 864-511-320 has also joined us tonight. Thanks so much for watching. And anti-postmodernism thinks we should give away that fur coat next week.
I was a kid in Chipley, Georgia.
See if we can track that down.
There's also Chipley, Florida. But they have both been subsequently eradicated from the map.
Still, if somebody can enlighten me who Daryl is, the FCC Hill Band is mentioned.
No.
I missed it. This gentleman here is Patrick O'Neill, and you probably recognize him from quite a bit of television and film, but two classic horror films that he starred in was The Stepford Wives, the original Stepford Wives, and a classic Larry Cohen horror film called The Stuff, which is actually quite good. If you haven't seen it, I would strongly suggest it.
Potato salad, macaroni, everything you like.
I'll have bologna.
Anti-postmodern has that fur coat.
No. Some of
and
that
is going to drop it off at the station so we can put it, raffle it off next week.
The delectation man took a personal interest in its selection.
Oh, well, we got lucky again. That's early 1970. That's
looks like Rocky stumbled. Munson's a fan of Larry Cohen's film, too? The Stuff.
Of course you may.
Thank you.
Rocky Munson, I want you to remind me about The Stuff after this break. We're going to break here and I want to tell a little story about that.
It must have been wonderful.
What?
The people who lived here. They must have had a wonderful life.
Well, I hope they did. Wilfred Butler must have believed.
Thanks so much for everybody who's called in so far. We've had SR211 or Sonny. Who's complaining about the noise? Doug Danger. And Herman Jolly. Portland. On a conference call. Got him in the raffle.
Now someday they're gonna come in here.
I love that sweater. Love that sweater.
Little tract houses all over this property on Quarter
Acre
and half.
More opportunities coming up here to give us a call and talk to Hank and get you into that raffle.
And it's going to get the surprise of its life.
There seems to be a lot of discussion about that fur coat that we might be off, raffling off next week. Atomic Voice says he needs one. He's looking for a size large.
Wants money. You know, he's asking $50,000 cash for this place, and if the only way he can get, he can get at least $250,000. But he won't take his time. So he'll get
a sandwich there. We'll be right back after these messages.
Back in the wild frontier. Things aren't always as they seem.
God help us all.
A mother with nothing left to lose.
My son and husband were killed.
Must join forces with a town held hostage.
Wiped out half the town. There's nothing we can do.
By a ruthless, supernatural outlaw.
Yeah, it's like he ain't even human.
Think of me as a ghost.
But when a mysterious stranger rides into town...
Is that your name? Pelchidian?
A phantom warrior sworn to protect the righteous. They're caught in the showdown between good and evil. Denise Crosby from Star Trek The Next Generation, Angus Scrimm from Phantasm, and Robert McRae in the ultimate dual role.
You're watching Channel 67. Amter TV. Broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Well, hello there. At first glance, you failed to recognize me. But you must live a rare life of seclusion, and I pity you for that. For the rest of you, you know this striking visage is none other than I, famed author, noted personality, and the host of television, Unexplained Explained, Walter D. Zart. And I'm here today to talk to you about one thing and one thing only. Pizza. What kind of pizza, you ask? Why, only the best. The most wondrous. The most mysterious pizza out there today. That's right. I am talking about Pisterdomus' Pizza Prophecies.
To go upstairs now?
Soon. You know, one of the great pleasures in life.
We're back.
The pleasure.
Hank Miller, pleasure. Host with Now It's Dark, watching Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972.
Sure, honey.
Directed by Theodore Gashani, co-produced by the famous Lloyd Kaufman from the Trauma fame, starring Patrick O'Neill, Mary Warnoff, and John Carradine. Want to thank Atomic Boy 61, Rob G in Arizona, JMO Session, FCC Gila Bend, Doug Danger, Jubilee from Portland watching tonight, Stock Trailer Mike, Rocky Munson, and then we even had the former chairman of Canon Films, Matt Golan, watching as well. Thanks for tuning in.
Anything doing?
No, sir. But look at this.
More football.
All right, huh? Rocky.
Look how they smeared that quarterback.
The stuff.
Look at his arm.
I think you're a fan of that film. Good movie.
How about that telephone?
I was at a film festival a few years back, and I believe the film that was at the festival I was watching was Cabin Fever. And the name of the director is escaping me right now. Did the remake of Death Wish.
Hello?
Can you help me out with that?
Oh, yes, Miss Howard. Yeah, the phone's working fine. Very nice.
Big Quentin Tarantino fan was
Thank
in.
Thank you.
Eli Roth, yes, that's right.
Honey, I'm
Eli
going
Roth
down the
was
car to get some cigarettes. Back
fever.
In a minute.
Okay.
Don't get lonely.
And,
oh, no.
I was out in the hallway and I was talking with him and telling him how much I really liked the film. And he really seemed to appreciate the fact that I enjoyed the movie. But I then mentioned to him that it really reminded me in some ways of The Stuff. And he seemed to be offended by that, and he just turned and walked away. So. I guess he doesn't like that movie. So, we'll have the phone line up here in a shortly. Tonight we're giving away a coffee mug, Hank's visage on it. Every caller tonight gets put into a raffle drawing. Is that her coat or is that some kind of animal hide? I think that's her coat.
Did you get your cigarettes?
Yeah.
Phone lines are open.
May I have one?
Sure.
You'd like to be in it for the drawing, for the mug?
These cigarettes.
Give old Hank a call. 520-329-2866.
Mm-hmm. Can I open it?
No. Our Christmas is day after tomorrow.
Is that an order?
Yes, ma'am. That's an order.
Rob G in Arizona says, we only had budget for one fur. Several comments about this wallpaper as well. Oh, we have a call. You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Errol?
What's on your mind? Oh, Daryl. Daryl. You're calling from FCC Heel Band?
Yeah, so my camera now kicked me off the board, so I can't watch the podcast now.
Sorry to hear that, Daryl. I'm glad you're watching tonight a little bit, or you can call in.
I'm not watching now. I'm in the basement.
Oh. Well, how did you get our number? That's no problem. We can do that, and we also have all our calls broadcast on our website. Quite a scene in there right now, Daryl. It's quite bloody. I gotcha. Sure. Hey, Daryl, can I ask you one quick question before I let you go? Do you have any information on Terror Joe and his how he's doing there? Is he still incarcerated?
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm pretty positive. He's like 3 cells down from me. Like, not cells. He's in a cell. I'm like in a closet. The boys just kind of locked me in. But no, he's doing pretty good. Tavern Act, he can like play chess and stuff, which is pretty cool.
Bill, someone's calling from Butler House.
Really good at chess.
Okay, come on.
But we told him he could go.
Go ahead now.
And he hasn't left yet, so I don't know.
Mr. Carter?
I'll talk to him again, though.
We're trying to set up an interview with him for next week's show, so hoping that will happen.
Butler.
Hey, Daryl, we'll put you into the drawing, so thanks so much for calling.
Oh,
speak up, I can't hear you.
I'm so sad.
Great. Thanks, Daryl. Have a great night.
What is it?
Okay.
What's wrong?
Be safe in that closet.
Yeah, but he's gone. Won't you come?
Okay, okay. Now you
stay. I guess that's Daryl I've been asking about.
Please, hurry.
Now, take it easy. I'm coming.
Oh, wow, they got a cool phone like Hank's. Oh, there's the communications director right there.
Mr. Butler, are you done?
Tess, I have come back.
What's that?
Tess, I want to see you.
Jay Mosesian's praying for Terror Joe,
who
I guess.
Who is this?
What's happening? So like this creepy voice.
Don't be long.
Tess.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
The communications director's a little bit rattled. So I mentioned before, the director of this movie is Theodore Gashani. He was married to Mary Warnoff when they made this film. She's no longer married. I think he's passed away now. Theodore only made two other feature films, one called Chemic and another one called Sugar Cookies.
Oh my God, where is everybody?
Both of them starred Mary Warnoff. Sugar Cookies was a softcore porn film that was produced by Lloyd Kaufman and Oliver Stone early in his career.
So, oh, Maggie, thank goodness.
A little tidbit there.
Something's come up, something urgent. Can you start early?
Oh, honey, I'm watching TV.
Maggie Daly, you get yourself over here.
What?
Just get moving, Maggie. Just please hurry.
All these phone calls tonight, I gotta say, I'm not following the plot in this movie very well. Jay Mosesian says, Sugar Cookies, well, that ruined my Christmas baking. That's a good one, Jay Mosesian. We might have to interview in the drawing for the mug just for that one. Oh my gosh, we got another call. We'll be going to break soon here, so hopefully we can get this in. You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Hey, Hank, what's your name? Sam.
Sam? Where are you calling from? Where are you calling from tonight, Sam? Calling from Lake Charles, Louisiana. How are we coming in?
Great. You got a strong signal.
Excellent.
Come on, kid.
So you
got very well.
And you said you're in law enforcement?
Yeah. You may recognize me by my porn mustache.
Come in.
Porn mustache, great. Well, what's on your mind tonight? Did you just call in to enter for the mug, or?
Okay, mister, that's far enough. What do you want here?
Cool-looking coffee mug.
Well, that's awesome. We'll get you in for the mug. We really appreciate you watching. How are you enjoying the film tonight?
No.
Looks like we might need some law enforcement right now in this film, but.
What are you staring at?
I seem to remember.
That's why I'm holding the gun. You scare me.
The acting is stellar.
Does everybody carry one?
You can ask the sheriff.
Are you familiar with Lloyd Kaufman and his work?
Oh, little bit.
Sheriff's office is empty.
I won't say I follow religiously, but I've seen that a little bit.
Hey, Lloyd Kaufman released a film,
Jeffrey Butler,
one of the best films ever made in Arizona,
well,
called Dog Years, from a great filmmaker in Tucson by the name of Robert Loomis.
Have you any idea?
If you haven't seen it, you should check it out. But Troma released it.
I want your ID. Some maniac escaped from Margaretville.
Was Dog Years a sequel to Dog Years?
No, it wasn't. It's just Dog Years. Yeah, no, it's Dog Years. So... Well, really appreciate you calling in tonight, Sam, from Lake Charles. That's awesome. And I'm glad our signal is strong and you can receive us from so far away.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Okay. Enjoy talking to you.
Thanks for calling, Sam. Appreciate it.
Okay.
Bye.
The last kind word I hear in my dad say.
I'm shocked they would let someone like you out. 25 years is not enough.
I'm a new man, but the new life, I'm not going back.
A wicked man flees, though no one pursues. Those who forsake the law praise the wicked. Evil men do not understand justice. He who conceals his sin shall not prosper. A man tormented by the guilt of murder will be a fugitive until death. Let no one support him.
Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Tapes from numerous locals with strong evidence that we are being visited from beings beyond the stars. I must warn you, what you are about to see is highly disturbing.
Hey, Ed, is that you? Ida, you out here, girl? What in the hell is going on here? Oh my God! It's like the size of a building.
They say the truth is out there, but it's happening right here in Gila Bend. Stay safe, my friends.
Operators are standing by. You're watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Back. It's Hank Miller with Now It's Dark. We're watching Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972.
My maniac card from the asylum.
Directed by Theodore Gushani.
I'll give you one when you escape.
Co-produced by the famous Lloyd Kaufman from Troma. Starring Patrick O'Neill, who's already dead.
My father's in Wilton getting your money.
Mary Warnoff and John Carradine.
All I want to do is to get into my house.
The sheriff's deputy might have a key. He's about the only one I know of.
So thanks so much for Sam for calling in from Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Before the break. White fence.
And then you can't.
Rocky Munson says this guy here looks like Driller, the man from Driller Killer. That is not Abel Ferreira, Rocky, but he does kind of look like him. And looks like anti-postmodernism likes his coat.
If I don't call back in an hour.
Anti-postmodernism.
Call the mayor.
A bit of a fashionista.
And nobody else. Promise me you'll do that.
Well, sure.
Mark it down, honey. So you'll have it.
Rob G in Arizona. Yes, we have seen John Carradine.
I'm heading west on Route 5 to Butler House.
One of the folks at the table. Early on. Got another call.
What the hell?
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Hey, Kitty. Hey, Globa. I love what you're doing, baby.
Thanks so much for calling. It means a lot to a small station like this. That we can show quality work that you've done like this film here.
Oh, yeah. Normally, we would probably be in touch because you're showing off our stuff, but we love it. We love amateur TV. We're looking at possibly picking it up, so
taking
it international.
Oh, Mr. Golan, that would be amazing. Been a big fan of your work for many years. You know, the Chuck Norris franchises and the Charles Bronson stuff from the 70s. Just great stuff.
Me and Chuck, yeah, we would do crazy things. You could not imagine what me and him would do in a wild night in Beirut, you know. Oh my gosh. But yes. But likewise, we also love amateur TV and very inspired by your working, so keep it up.
Oh,
keep it up.
Thank you so much. Can we put you in the drawing for the mug? Would you like that?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Thank you so much for calling. It's an honor. It really is. Thank you so much for watching.
I love you. I love MSFTV.
All right. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Wow. Can you believe that?
Did you find the deputy?
Not going, calling Gila Bend and amateur.
I was thinking.
Amateur TV.
Isn't
that's amazing.
Lawyer supposed to be at the house?
The door was locked. His car was there, so I borrowed it.
You mean you stole a car?
Wow. Highlight.
Yeah.
You know, last show we did that little video where I met Roger Corman. You know.
Who's coming to dinner?
And opportunity to talk on the phone with Mr. Golan like that.
We always have dinner every Thursday.
That was awesome. Thanks for calling. We'll put you in for the drawing.
Something? No, I hate Paradise Motel.
Yeah, I know. It's awful. What about a drink?
Yeah.
J. Momsesian says that Mary Warnoff was in Rock and Roll High School. That's right.
Big family around here.
She was, and I believe she was also in Rock and Roll High School Forever.
No, straight.
Roger Corman, New World Productions. So.
You look tired.
I am tired.
Atomic Boy says,
to a fast dollar.
First celebrity call, yes. Very first celebrity call we've gotten here at the station. I think before we got the call, I was dressing Rob G in Arizona. Yeah, we have seen John Carradine. He was with the mayor and the communications director at the beginning of the film.
What's it like?
I believe we're going to see him here shortly here.
You know, I've never seen the inside.
Coming up.
When I was a child, my father told me to stay away from it, or something terrible might happen. Sort of like a haunted house.
I haven't seen it either.
You're going to sell it? You've never seen it?
Now, Mary Warnoff, as I mentioned, she had a long collaboration, friendship with Paul Bartel.
It's probably nice to see around here.
Appeared in 17 films
I
with him.
Someone keeps calling with a message.
She appeared in one of my favorite Roger Corman productions, Death Race 2000, which was directed by Paul Bartel.
Why not in the reception room?
Oh, I don't know. It's not a voice that I know.
I better go on.
Can I come too?
Atomic Boy asks if if Mr. Golan is eligible to win the mug, I think we will.
I suppose you'd be going back
We will put in for the raffle, yes.
said you lived there, remember?
No, I'll be traveling.
Yes. As Rob G. in Arizona
Jeff,
says,
look,
he did call in.
It's the sheriff's car.
Oh, I think here's John Kerrigan. I think that John Kerrigan will be coming up here, Rob. Thanks for everybody who's tuned in tonight. Stock Trailer Mike, FCC Gila Ben, J Mobsession, SR211, Atomic Boy, Rob G in Arizona.
There's a light.
We had Doug Danger.
Look at that tombstone.
Jubilee from Portland.
Pretty cheerful.
Sorry, I'm probably missing some folks. We had a call from Sam. From Lake Charles, thanks so much for everybody for calling in and in the chats.
My grandfather.
Oh.
Someone left their sunglasses in the snow.
They're the sheriff's.
My lawyer's missing, so is the sheriff.
Stock Trailer Mike is asking, did you get the shovel?
And now someone's fascinated by
shovel?
My grandfather's grave.
Are we digging somebody up?
Let's
I'm having a hard time following this film tonight.
You still want to go to my house?
Yes. But I don't want to go alone.
Phone lines are open. 520-329-2866.
Well, of course you're not.
Oh, it's the cold. I'm shaking from it.
We aim to try...
Let's get out of here.
He's asking if we've seen any more aliens in Gila Bend.
Okay.
We'll get help in time.
I have not heard anything recently, but I would like to ask our viewers out there... I've been hearing this constant hum and buzz, just low. I'm wondering if anybody else out there in Gila Bend has heard this as well. Rob G. in Arizona says, second fur. Did I miss some stock for the mic? Did somebody take a shovel to the back of the head?
Night, Mr. Tolman.
We did see some hatchet going into some folks that were in bed. That was Patrick O'Neill earlier in the film. Oh, got ourselves another call. Phone's ringing off the hook. There's John Carradine right there. You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller? Hey, Jerry, thanks for calling. How are we coming in out there in L.A.?
Pretty clear.
Great.
We're really enjoying this movie, and we're enjoying the audio in this movie.
That's great. Have you seen this film before, Jerry?
Actually, I hadn't seen the film. I know about it, but hadn't seen it yet.
Are you familiar with the work of Lloyd Kaufman and Mary Warnock?
Sure. Yes, and Mary Warren, of course, right. Her resume is huge. And, of course, lots of people remember her from Rock and Roll High School and Eating Gravel.
Great films. You know, my favorite film that she was in was Death Race 2000. Have you seen that movie?
Of course, yes. I used to work at Roger Corman.
Oh, it's a great film.
Deputy's not
Roger,
here, but
wonderful
is.
Man. You know, I had an opportunity to meet Roger at a club. We had a video of it last week.
I saw it. It was awesome. Yeah. He was great on camera there. Yeah. A natural born actor.
Are you calling so you can get in the drawing for the mug?
Sure, because
Mr. Tolman,
I want to get
wait.
By Hank.
Okay.
No, please. I have to talk to you.
So, as long as I can get my
I'm
name
sorry. This is Jeffrey Butler.
There,
he's the one who's selling
the
house.
Get my hopes.
He can't get inside the place.
Great.
Hey,
we'll also give out stickers. If you send us a email us your address, we'll mail you some stickers as well. So we love our fans and viewers.
Yeah, I like stickers. I need, you know, I've got about 4,600 stickers on the back of my station wagon.
Oh.
Tess.
I could use another one or two.
Well, that'd be great. We'd love to have Hank on the back of the car.
Why would you go there?
I don't know.
Well, back to the movie.
Hey, thanks for calling, Jerry. Really appreciate it.
You say it's locked.
All right. Hey, everybody out there.
Thanks for calling, Jerry, from L.A. That's awesome.
All right, bye.
Drive there?
Jerry from Los Angeles. He said he worked for Roger Corman.
I need a key.
That's amazing. We were showing Roger Corman's film Bucket of Blood last week, and like I said, I had an opportunity to meet Roger at Club Red 71. We had a little video of that. Robin, Arizona, there he is right there. John Carradine, the old man there. I think he's got a hearing aid in there. All right, stock trailer, Mike. You're telling me that somebody got hit in the back of the head with a shovel? I must have been on the phone. I missed that. Can anybody else confirm that? Rob G in Arizona says, great acting family.
We'll
That's
be right,
right
back after these messages.
See your Magus tonight?
No, I am on Big Brother detail this week. My little brother Corey's in town.
Are you kidding me, man? That's perfect. Who are you to limit his college experience, huh?
My main man, what's going on?
Chilling, man. I think I picked something up on the fucking booze cruise.
This place is usually bumping at this time.
I hate the week after spring break. Everyone brings back some sort of sick shit with them.
Anybody call the cops yet?
All the lines are busy.
It's pretty safe in here, right? That door is a solidus rock. I said we just stay chill here for a while, right?
Great. Dormers are freaking dead.
We're gonna need a place to go after this, and the studio seems like the safest spot.
You grab something to defend yourselves with. We're moving out.
This is how it always starts. Somebody gets curious. Curious George goes out the door, and then boom!
Here comes the show.
I'm sorry, but when I see somebody hungering for my sweet, succulent brain flesh, I call them a zombie.
College is going to rock.
You're watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Experience the sound.
Have I experienced some like any other? Players just come to me. I see that they have been rated number one in quality assurance and customer service. At Pisodomus, every employee is handpicked for their psychic ability and mental prowess. Like this young man right here, so he can deliver on our famed motto.
If we forget to predict the toppings on your order before you've made your order, then because we forgot to do that, it's going to be discounted at 50% off of the order. So half off the pizza because I didn't do it right.
Great, and that's a sightseer's guarantee.
Mom!
Experience. You're going to finish that.
Gad is the owner and operator of MMTR-TV in Gila Bend. He was last seen looking for his dog Ide on Old Benson Highway. If you've seen Big Ed or Ide, please call 520-329-2866.
You're watching Channel 67. Amter TV. Broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Oh man, this isn't my house. It's Tess's.
We're back. Hank Miller here, host of Now It's Dark. Tonight we're watching Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972. Directed by Theodore Gershani. Co-produced by Lloyd Kaufman from Troma. Starring Patrick O'Neill, Mary Warnoff, and John Carradine.
Well, Tess isn't here.
We just had a commercial, Paestrama's Pizza. And looks like Anti-Postmodernism just said that he ordered some from Paestrama's, but it hasn't shown up yet. Anti-Postmodernism, I hope you mentioned
she hates it.
That Hank sent you. And they should have given you $1 off your order.
Maybe she went to see the woman.
Best pizza
there.
In town.
Someone called the mayor's house before. Said she'd be waiting.
Stock Trailer Mike asks if this is a Christmas film.
What is it?
I believe this film takes place around Christmas Eve. This film also had a long history of playing on late night horror host shows like this one at Christmas time. We're a bit late adopters here at Amateur TV. We should have shown this back in December. Hope you're enjoying the film, Stock Trailer Mike. We got a call this evening from Mom Golan, chairman,
Hello,
president
Chair?
Of Canon Films. What an honor.
Hello.
So this film is a Canon
there?
Release. Canon was created in 1967.
I'm Diane Adams.
Is really
I spoke to you before.
Famous for the Chuck Norris franchises and Charles Bronson series of films in the late 70s and 80s. Also responsible for the Rambo.
Who are you?
Franchise. Oh.
Hello? Hello?
Christmas Eve, 1935. William Detroit says that Chuck Norris is his dad. 704, signal 10, 704, phone lines are open if you'd like an opportunity to win the Hank coffee mug. Here it is with that nice visage. Have a big cup of Hank every morning. Every one of our callers this evening will be entered into a drawing. Then at the end of the show tonight, we'll draw names out of the cup or hat, and have a winner. That there is the communications director, that lady right there, of the town. A lot of celebrity connections tonight. Monat Golan, we aim to try, is the son of Chuck Norris. Jerry called in, worked for the famous Roger Corman.
Sheriff, I saw your car.
Stock Trailer Mike says he's enjoying the film. Thinks we have great programming. You must not watch very much television, Stock Trailer Mike, but thanks for saying so.
Bill? Is that you?
Cult leader 864511320. Thanks for watching tonight.
Ah!
We usually don't allow advertisements on our show, unsolicited, but it appears that FCC Gila Ben. Was looking for a new technical system.
I remember that face. You are older now. And that. But still, Tess. And you're frightened, aren't you? Don't be afraid. I want to help you. Take my hand. Take it, Tess.
Poor Tess.
The person on the telephone said 1935, Christmas Eve.
Oh, anyways.
But that's
we
not
usually don't do unsolicited advertising, but FCC Heal Ben says they're looking for a new technical assistant at the station.
After that, I find social
please
notes,
apply in person.
Parties, nothing special. Then, in 1930, Butler's wife, Catherine, dies of tuberculosis. In August 1933, it stars Wilfred Butler's daughter is cruelly attacked.
And we got ourselves another call.
Her name is Marianne, the same name as the caller who left those messages.
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
She's 15, darling.
Oh, yes, Hank, it's me, Mike.
On May 2nd, 1934, Marianne Butler gives
me... I'm doing well, Mr. Habernathy. I hope we're in compliance this evening.
Jeff. Early in 1935, Butler House is turned over to a Dr. Robinson as an asylum for mental patients. And then Butler goes on to say that he has committed his own daughter. Marianne will live at the asylum. There's no end to this story.
Well, we're more than happy to do a public service announcement, and you've been so helpful and good to the station. We're pleased to let you advertise your job opening. And of course, you know, we'd love to have somebody in the community with a job if they need it. Mr. Habernathy? Mr. Habernathy?
Everything we do for you as you look in, I'd like to ask you a favor.
Sure.
See, Daryl is my son-in-law, half-wit, kind of idiot kid, and has fire of the day.
Oh.
But pretty sure you have an opening at the station, and maybe bring Daryl on as like an intern of some
sort.
Sure. We can always use an intern. Why don't you have him come on down on Monday and we'll have him speak to Floyd. Floyd can walk him through the paces and show him around a bit.
Super duper. That's fantastic. All right.
Mr. Habernathy, before you go, can I ask you a question?
I don't want to talk about it.
Go for it.
Just calling to see if we could possibly schedule an interview with Terror Joe. We'd love to check in with him and see how he's doing.
My mother died in childbirth.
Maybe put him on the air for an interview next week. Do you think that might be possible?
It's not what the paper said.
Mr. Habernathy?
What's your point?
I just thought that you should read
something. Mr. Habernathy?
For your own good. Ooh.
Well, a bad connection here, Mr. Habernathy.
My past to future would be for my
own good. Well, I'll have Daryl come by. We can sort out the interview and do this off air.
Great. And, hey, we're giving away a coffee mug tonight. We'll put you in for the drawing. Thanks for calling, Mr. Habernathy. I appreciate it.
Yeah, over now.
Over now. Man, another call. Mr. Habernathy from the FCC Gila Bend. That sounds good. We're hoping to maybe get an interview with Terror Joe next
week. Maybe your mother's still alive. Maybe she's waiting for you at the house.
I don't know.
I'm not sure where the thread was going here, but Atomic Boy says he has skills in toaster repair and years of experience with screwdrivers. You might be a perfect candidate for the position there, Atomic Boy. Dave Moncessi and Mr. Abernathy said that Daryl was his half-wit son and nephew and had the fire in. Yeah, that was Daryl from the closet. Thank you everybody for calling in tonight. Ooh, calling on fire. Thanks for all the chats tonight and the calls. Hope you're enjoying the film. I can't say that I am. I'm having a hard time keeping track of the movie. It's kind of cool. I'm in fire right now.
It's empty.
If you're watching, Mr. Abernathy, it looks like Atomic Boy 61 will be applying for your new position. I think we can get a good reference to here from the station. Been a loyal viewer.
Jeff, look!
When we come back from the break, I'd like to tell you a bit more about Sonar. We're going to commercial here shortly.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Where are you? What's going on?
Charlie Regis was killed tonight.
One to the forehead.
You sunk a lot of dough in Charlie's joint. What did you and him fight about tonight?
One of you two killed Charlie. I find out who soon, or I kill you both.
I saw somebody driving away. Could have been anybody.
You've got to help me locate Del before it gets to Charlie.
Whatever I've done for her.
You're watching Channel 67 Amter TV. Broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Something's coming, folks. Or in actuality, already here.
Darling, I'm telling you, I've been hearing weird stuff all night. Just want to see what it is. Holy shit! It's one of them flying saucers. Look at it move. Hello? Something there? Hello?
They say there, but it's happening right here in Gila Bend. Stay safe, my friends.
Operators are standing by. You're are watching Channel 67, Amateur TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Stay back!
It's Tarman!
Stay back!
We're back. Hank Miller here, host of Now It's Dark. Tonight we're watching Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972. It was starring John Carradine. John Carradine just got run over by a car. Patrick O'Neill was starring in it earlier, but he got the hatchet. Currently starring Mary Warnoff. There seems to be a lot of killing going on in this movie. Shovels, hatchets, garden tools, wrenches. Let's talk to the mic. Was letting me know that the communications director lady lost her digits.
Somebody cut off his hands.
You killed him. You killed
him. We got a lot of phone calls tonight. Thank you so much for all those phone calls.
He's asking for help.
Special guest call from Menachem Golan, former president chair of Canon Films. What an honor to have Mr. Golan call. Thank you so much. Tonight we're giving away this fine coffee mug with the Hank visage. All callers will be entered into a raffle, and we'll draw the name at the end of the show to see who wins that fine coffee mug. Atomic Boy says he's praying for that mug. Oh, good news. We just heard from FCC Gila Bend that Tara Jo is available and would like to do an interview for us next week. So it'd be nice to check in with Tara Jo and see how he's doing. Maybe tell us a little bit about why he took over the station a couple months ago.
Butgrass.
So this film was co-produced by Lloyd Kaufman. Lloyd Kaufman started his career early, doing some work with Canon Films. So he was a co-producer on this movie. Lloyd Kaufman also worked on a early Canon film called Joe, which was a drama with Peter Boyle, who I believe was nominated for an Academy Award for it, and was directed by the fine director John Avildsen. You recognize John Avildsen as the director of Rocky and the Karate Kid franchise.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, what?
This is Marianne Butler. I'm calling from my house. Won't you come over here, Mr. Mayor? We're having a reunion. Everyone's here.
Creepy phone caller. Love it. So Lloyd Kaufman did a lot of work with Canon early on. In 1974, he started his own company. You might have heard of it, Troma. Troma's famous for their series of bad films, bad cheap films. And most famous character, the Toxic Avenger. Uh, We talked about Roger Corman last week, and Roger Corman is often described as king of the bees. I would say Lloyd Kaufman is king of the Z's, but he has quite a following and has quite a large body of work of producing a lot of schlocky, no-budget films that really do have quite a cult following. And I was mentioning to our phone caller, Sam, Troma released a lot of films from filmmakers, one of them being a great film called Dog Years, directed by Robert Loomis. No one shall ever see an amazing my beloved daughter, independent film from the 90s. If you ever get a chance Jeffrey, to see that movie, I'd really strongly suggest it. I write for myself in the hope of forgiveness if that is still possible. One of my other favorite films released by Troma was a movie called Combat Shock, which is a bit of a mix between Falling Down and Eraserhead. If you ever get a chance to see that movie, Combat Shock, I strongly suggest that as well.
The child Jeffrey was taken from us and sent to California.
Mr. Golan, of course, has been friends with Lloyd Kaufman for a long time. Mr. Golan says, though, he's much shorter than he appears.
Useless. All of it. I remembered what she had been. There was never a lovelier, happier child.
We aim to try, says there. Look, he's looking, hopefully wants to win that mug, but also says that you can buy it from our gift shop. That's right. This is a special edition one, though, we aim to try. It's a little bit different than the one we sell in the gift shop.
Ladies and gentlemen, quiet, please. I propose a toast. Doctor, please.
By Christmas
Atomic
of the first
Boy 61
year,
says that he that cast act, Lloyd Kaufman in a cameo myself, for my in a film child, called Tomorrow by Midnight.
Our friend. I had no plan. All I knew was that I must take her from these men with their promises.
What kind of film was that, Atomic Boy? Was that a horror film or a comedy, or what was the genre of that?
For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can.
I hope everybody's enjoying the film tonight. I have no idea what we're watching. I really have not been able to follow this film at all.
I knew they would gorge themselves into a stupor that afternoon. It was their celebration. I expected no less. Since they had come into
some
my house,
good moments
they had
in it, though. I have to say, I love the creepy voice on the phone.
They had behaved like
and
when
the communications director got it, the digits
finally,
packed off.
Control.
That was a pretty interesting scene as well. Wow, that's quite a genre, Atomic Boy. Hostage film in a video store. Did Lloyd play himself in the movie? Stock Trailer Mike, maybe you can
dinner, they danced and drank, and
give a call to the station sometime and tell us what this movie is about.
Reassure me. They expected me to believe because I had no choice. Wilfred, trust me. He really believed Marianne would be well.
I'm assuming
he saw
this,
a light. There is a light at the end of a long
here.
Tunnel.
There is a light.
Anyway,
at the end of
a couple things about Lloyd Kaufman as well. Since he was friends with John Avildsen through his early days at Canon, even after Lloyd started his company, Troma Films, he actually had opportunity to do some work on Rocky, Saturday Night Fever,
I left
and I believe the Louis Malle film, My Dinner with Andre. So, Lloyd Kaufman as a Yale graduate, went to school with Oliver Stone and George W. Bush. This is a very interesting man, series of contradictions when you look at the kind of work that he makes. Phone lines are still open, 520. Excuse me, I gotta wait till I get here on the ticker here. 520-329-2866. If you want an opportunity to join our raffle for the mug, please give us a call. That's right, Stock Trailer Mike, this blown out sepia tone really gives it that old-timey look. Atomic Boy, it sounds like an interesting movie. Was it any good? Lloyd Kaufman playing a video store manager. Looks like we got ourselves a call. You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Hi, Hank. This is Rob G. and AZ.
Hey, Rob. Hey, thanks for calling tonight. Thanks for watching.
Mike,
are you calling from, where are you calling from?
It was inhuman.
Gilbert, Arizona.
I had loved that's just not too far from Gila Bend. Our child, how's Kevin. The signal? Are we coming in clear?
I brought her to this.
Reception is real strong,
I swear,
Hank.
On that afternoon.
Awesome. What's on your mind tonight?
Was to save my child.
Oh, I just wanted to say thanks for what you're doing. I love the program. Started watching the last couple of weeks, and really would love to get in on that coffee mug action.
Great. We'll put you in for the drawing for the coffee mug. Thanks so much for watching tonight. Are you enjoying the film?
My hope was to get her away from that house.
I got it.
Also,
I
wanted to set free those other wreckers who had so long been abused by the doctors.
And the flashback scene that we just I've enjoyed the program.
Great. Well, thanks so much for calling tonight, Rob. We'll put you in for that drawing and hope you win that mug.
All right. Thank you very much, Hank. Have a great evening.
You too. Thanks for calling. Wow, great. Another caller. It's going to be tough competition for that mug tonight.
I knew what they might do if these inmates were freed. And this is my guilt. I knew. And still, I freed them.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Now quit daydreaming about the life you don't have. Get busy living the one you do.
And one of these days I'm gonna just go.
You gonna get yourself lost out there?
I need to report a crime. This girl is chained.
And the girl, how's she now?
You have money, right?
Cops are looking for a young man that robbed a... What was it again, Rocky?
Department store.
Down around Milton. Young man, they're looking for fits your description.
Mister, I'm just passing through.
Call me Hart.
You are exactly who I say you are.
Find him. Bring him in.
You are lost to the world, boy.
There's a downside to getting lost.
You become more trouble than you're worth.
Getting found.
You're watching Channel 67. Amter TV. Broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Experience.
Experience.
You're gonna finish that song.
Handcrafted to perfection, cooked to pure bliss. With a sauce so savory and sweet, it could only be crafted with a secret recipe as illustrious and mysterious as the company's founder, chef, and esteemed magician, Amadeus von Nostromo.
So trust me, New York Post best-selling author, fictional revolutionary, maverick, and all-around handsome man. When you're feeling hungry, pick up that phone and call. But don't be surprised when they tell you what you want to order. And remember, experience. The Zaw.
Heist Drama's Pizza Promises 555-7792, corner of Craig Crompton Speedway. Call now and experience the Zaw.
Watching Channel 67. Enter TV. Broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
We're back. I'm Hank Miller, your host, and now it's dark. We're watching tonight Silent Night, Bloody Night from 1972. We're in the last segment of the film. We're giving a mug away tonight. The special edition Hank coffee mug. All callers who call in will be entered for a drawing. And right after the movie, we'll draw a name out of the hat and see who wins that mug. Okay, let's see if I get this right. Was this house an insane asylum and are people escaping? I really haven't been paying that much of attention. A couple chats here I want to respond to before we get too far. Atomic Boy says the movie that Lloyd Kaufman was in that he did the casting on was a 2001 Dog Day Afternoon in a Video Store. That sounds like a really great movie. Yes, Atomic Boy, there's a record number of calls tonight. I guess if I give away something, people might call in. Rocky, I do not know what's going on. So also tonight, after the movie, we're going to draw to see who wins that mug. And then directly following that, we have a short video presentation. I did an interview recently with a news station about the disappearance of Big Ed Winters. And so stay tuned to see who wins that mug. And then right afterwards, see me being interviewed about Big Ed's disappearance. So we've got the sepia tone. Looks like maybe insane asylum and some like well-dressed people at a party. Christmas music. Let me talk about these inmates here real quick. A lot of folks in this film were part of Andy Warhol's Superstars. What that means is part of Andy Warhol's entourage, actors that were in his films or people who were subject of his art or just part of his social circle. That included Mary Warnoff, filmmaker Jack Smith, and artist Susan Rothenberger. Jack Smith was a experimental filmmaker that helped sort of bring in the aesthetic of camp film, camp trash film, and really was an inspiration. Jack Smith inspired the work not only of Andy Warhol, but of the great John Waters. John Waters was definitely influenced by Jack Smith. I don't know which one of these inmates is Jack Smith, but he's one of them. The artist Susan Rothenberger was a painter, and at the end of her career and her life, she worked out of New Mexico, and her work is really compared a lot to fascinating connections in this film. Dr. Mike says, I consider myself a smart man, but this film has me questioning myself.
After the inmates started to the house,
I believe a lot of the reviews of this film say something similar. It's a bit hard to follow.
I do not know exactly when she slipped away from me. I assume.
Rob G in Arizona says, didn't he go missing about the same time as Strange Lights in the Sky? Yeah, if you're talking about Big Ed, absolutely. A lot of strange things going on.
They killed her. Later.
Of course, if you know anything
and then most
about
of the, inmates fled,
the disappearance of Big Ed
where.
Or Ida, if you've seen them or know anything, please give us a call. We'd love to have
since
them
that Christmas,
come back home.
I have lived in prisons and asylums. Lived anonymously as an animal. I have wandered in
Cocktail Mike says cocktails and insanity meds don't mix.
All seasons yes, have become right. As one. And that is a
so we have some law enforcement. Still time if you haven't called in yet tonight, did like be entered for that drawing for the mug, you still have time to call. Phone lines are still open. Just give us a call, 520-329-2866. Thanks so much for everybody who called in tonight. And has been participating in the chat. Really appreciate it. James Obsession, Stock Trader on Mike. Jeff. Rob G in Arizona. FCC Gila Ben. Manat Golan. Atomic Boy, 61.
This is still his house.
Doug Danger. Jubilee from
Your
Portland.
Grandfather died in 1950.
Who else did I miss? We had Sam called in from Lake Charles.
My grandfather poured gasoline.
I know I'm missing some folks. Daryl from the closet.
But Tom wanted to believe you.
Thank you everybody for participating today in the show.
They still do.
But I'm going. If you could get some associates to help, that'd be great.
This house was an asylum.
We might need. You know,
there
some Chuck Norris or Charlie Bronson help
Tess,
out here in Gila Bend.
Bowman, the sheriff, your father.
No.
All inmates. They killed my mother in this room.
So Tommy Boy says that Marion Ross, the actress from Happy Days, that was the mom, wasn't it? She was part of the Andy Warhol Superstars. Or was she just playing in Love Boat that she was a superstar? She wasn't, in fact, but that was the storyline on Love
Who's
Boat.
That?
I did not make this up. It kind of sounds like you did make it up, Atomic Boy, but that's awesome. That's a cool story, Stock Trailer Mike. I mean, that's a cool story, Atomic Boy. Thanks for sharing that. Jay Mofsessian is absolutely correct. We need to watch more of that. I wonder if we can get those on this station. Mr. Golan, you know what? I mean, I'm not a movie guy or a movie executive, but you know, I think it'd be great to get with Chuck on those pictures. The actor Nicolas Cage. Nicolas Cage and Chuck Norris would make an amazing movie, don't you think?
Daddy?
Oh, okay, Atomic Boy clarified. So Marion Ross was playing the part in the story. That was part of the story. That's an amazing storyline for Love Boat. I don't remember that, but I'd love to see that episode. Thanks for sharing that, Atomic Boy. That's cool. I'm your father. Hey, Nicholas Cage has a restraining order against his call. All right. Please. Who is chasing Mary Warnock in this movie? After the broadcast tonight, I'm going to have to rewatch this movie. Remember to don't leave after the movie's over. We're going to do a drawing to see who wins this mug. And then we have a short video presentation right after that.
I spent that night weeping. By morning, there were no more tears.
I have to say, there were some nice visuals in this film, and I really liked some of the whispers on the phone call.
Both thought they were shooting at killers,
but I really don't know what this movie was about.
But they were simply the last victims in that house of victims.
Mary Warnoff was awesome, though.
And now,
she's great.
A year later, they will tear down Wilfred Butler's monument.
Laugh, 19, Nicholas Cage, Chuck Norris,
but
and Thomas Hayden Church.
Destroy my memories.
Thanks so much for tuning in tonight, Laugh, 19. Comic Boy 61, Stock Film Mike, not Golan. FCC Hero Band, Rob Jr., Arizona, James Obsession, Rocky Munson. Thank you everybody for tuning in tonight and playing along. Next week, we'll have a brand new show. We'll be back in 1 week with a new program. We'll have another giveaway as well, so looks like we have a pressing announcement from FCC Keel Ben. Tara Joe escaped with Daryl from the basement. We better lock our doors. So as soon as we get through the credits here, we'll do a drawing for the mug, and then right after that, we'll have a short video presentation that I was interviewed for. So Floyd wrote down everybody's name who called in. And put your name on the thing. So let's pull a name out of a hat here. Tonight's winner, Sam from Lake Charles, Louisiana, the man in law enforcement. Sam, if you're still watching us, please send us your address so we can mail you that mug. Thanks for calling in tonight, Sam. Thanks for everybody calling in tonight. My name is Hank Miller. I'm the host of Now It's Dark on Amateur TV.
What is Amateur TV?
Amateur TV is a small station in a small desert town of Gila Bend. It's owned and operated by Big Ed Winters.
Tell us about Big Ed.
Oh, Big Ed. He gave me my showbiz break, you know, hosting this show, Now It's Dark, here at Amateur TV. He's a great guy. He can be a little hot-tempered, really likes the ladies, but, you know, his two big loves are Ida and this station.
Who's Ida?
Oh, Ida, she's a station mascot and a resident canine. She's a rescue. Big Ed found her out on Old Benson Highway. You know where they see those mysterious lights, you know, fire in the sky? She's a real handful. She's addicted to chasing cars. But we love her.
Is there anybody else that works at the station?
Floyd, our engineer. We couldn't keep the station running without him. He's a bit of a chain smoker. Loner. You know, if he's not here at the station, he's usually hanging out at the community pool. Just standing around, watching.
So we all understand there's a reward for any information regarding Big Ed's disappearance.
Don't forget Ida, too.
Yes, of course, Ida, too. I understand there's an interview, maybe, that Big Ed did talking about some of the strange happenings here in Gila Bend.
Yes, there was an interview. Big Ed did do an interview. Unfortunately, the tape has been lost due to a small fire that happened at the station. Unfortunately, we lost episode 4 of Now It's Dark as well. Floyd sometimes falls asleep at the board, and he's always got a lit cigarette. We're pretty lucky the whole station didn't go up.
I was really hoping that we would be able to use that interview with Big Ed in this segment.
We do have a transcript, though. I could read it if you'd like.
Oh, that'd be great, Hank.
I was driving home out on Old Benson Highway. It was late, after midnight. No one on the road except an occasional coyote and pronghorn.
What's a pronghorn?
You know, it's like an antelope. Shall I continue?
Oh, yes. Sorry, Hank. Please do.
The glowing white lines were hypnotizing me, putting me to sleep. I was fighting the nods real hard when I saw something that got my adrenaline flowing. It was white, pale white skin and jet black hair. A woman, totally naked, you know, with no clothes on, just her birthday suit. She was stumbling and tripping right down the middle of the road. I swerved to miss her and slammed on the brakes. The car slid off the road and into the creosote brush. I looked into the rearview mirror. I could see she was continuing her journey, zigzagging down the highway. Her skin was now a reddish pink as the brake lights reflected off her bare skin. I jumped from the car, grabbing my sport coat from the seat, you know, to cover her up. But as I started to give chase, she was gone. I mean, disappeared, like was never there. Nothing on the road, just me holding my sport coat. You know, I never saw Big Ed in a sport coat. I think he was trying to be chivalrous there. Anyway, so I searched the desert for a little bit, didn't find anything, so I got back in my car and drove back to town, top speed.
Was Ida with Big Ed at the time of this?
Oh no. She was all laid up in the animal hospital with the amputation. Car chasing accident. It's a monkey on her back. Once she grabs onto that bumper, she just won't let go. Ended up in a 3-car pileup. There's more in the transcript. Do you want me to continue?
Yes, please, Hank. Sorry.
I went straight to the police and demanded to see Chief Miller. He came out of his office. I think he was sleeping. Told him the whole thing. You know what he said? He said, "Big Ed, you know drinking and driving is a serious crime." He didn't believe a word I said. Told me to walk back to the station and sleep it off. Hell, I just drove home, white-knuckled, looking for any sign of her in the pitch-black desert. Can you believe that? Come to think of it, I saw that bare-naked lady about where I found Ida a year ago. Ida was just wandering in the night, too, but I rescued her. The next night, I go to the station. God be damned, Floyd wasn't at his post again. We missed running that pizza parlor commercial again. We're in dire need of that Pistradamus account. Anyway, I found Floyd. He was out back smoking again. But Chief Miller was there, too, asking him questions about a dead body they found in the city pool. A real live dead body. Stranger, though. Not anyone from Gila Bend. Here's the bizarre thing. It's a woman with black hair, and she's nude.
Are you and Chief Miller related in any way?
No. It's a common name here in the borderland. There's just a little bit more. Do you want me to finish reading this?
Yes.
I had to go down to the cop shop and answer some questions. I left Floyd in charge. I had my own questions about this woman I saw on Old Benson Highway. How did she end up in the community pool? Chief Miller wanted me to see the body and confirm it was the same woman I saw in the desert. When we got to the coroner's office, she wasn't there. I mean, the body was gone. I then called into question Chief Miller's ability to do his job. He then locked me up.
They arrested Big Ed?
Yeah, they arrested Big Ed on suspicion. Had him jailed in for months till they finally dropped the charges. Come to think of it, he was only out a couple weeks before he disappeared. I hope your viewers see this story and they might create some leads or something. Because if anybody out there has seen Big Ed or Ida, please give us a call. We miss him and we want him to come home.
Ed is the owner and operator of MMTR-TV in Gila Bend. He was last seen looking for his dog Ida on Old Benson Highway. If you've seen Big Ed or Ida, please call 520-329-2866.
Club Red 71, open all night long. AC Tramp dog food sold everywhere.
Our national anthem.